Ciao guys, I want to show you a very cool new feature I integrated in PoseIt. But before I even start, let me do a flash recap about the core mechanics of this app. If you don't want to see it, feel free to skip ahead. There should be timestamps in the description. Okay, so the main principle to understand to easily pose your mannequin is that you must rotate its body parts in screen space. So I prepare this test scene to better explain this concept. So assume you have this marble floating in space, right? To make it spin, you would probably start doing this kind of movement, or this one to make it spin in this direction, and really anything in between. And instead, if you want to make it spin clockwise or counterclockwise, then you would probably do this kind of gesture. On top of that, you can also translate the sphere in space with this two fingers drag gesture. Now that you know how to interact with this marble, simply imagine the selected body part is glued on top of it. Also, something very important and useful, whenever you perform one of these gestures, you can do them anywhere on the screen. No need to start dragging on the body part or hit a specific axis on the gizmo, anywhere. No worries. You can do them anywhere on the screen, apart of course on the UI. There you go, okay. Let's go back to PoseIt to apply the same concept. Let's select the body part by tapping on it. If you want to deselect, just tap on an empty space. Then, so nothing is selected, your gesture will move the camera around. Something is selected, your gesture will move the selected body part. How do I know if something is selected? There is this little helpful gizmo over it. It also shows you which part can be rotated only. Showing you only those three arrows that, by the way, reflects the kind of rotation you're doing. See how the arrows move. And also which part can also be translated by showing you those little triangles on the sides. For instance, you can translate the head, the shoulders, and of course you can also translate the hips, which means you move the all relatives' body parts attached to it, or its children. There is this concept of parent and child joined. In CG, a skeleton is almost always represented like this tree structure, where the hip is the root and all the other parts are relatives or children of it. So the root moves everything, the abs move all its children, and so far and so on. So your edits will propagate forward in this hierarchy. This is what is called forward kinematic. And now that you know what forward kinematic is, it's time to show you the new feature. Inverse kinematic. If you look at the gizmo, when I select the feet or the hands, you will see that it is not a rotation-only gizmo anymore, but it is a rotation and translation gizmo. So now we can translate the foot with this two fingers drag gesture. We basically we are asking to a child joint to reach a point, and now his parent and grandparent, if you want, need to figure out how to make it go there. This is what it's called inverse kinematic. Ain't that cool? Oh, and by the way, thanks to Jose Diaz for making his code available on the Unity Asset Store. This really is the math and the core of inverse kinematics. So, while in previous version, if I wanted to move the hand on his hip, I had to figure out what angle the upper arm and the forearm had to have to reach that point. Now I can just drag the hand there and the app figures it out. And not only that, you can also select the shins and the forearms and do the same dragging to see where they need to point to. They will move without changing the position of the ending part of the limbs. Wait, there is more. Do you remember the lock orientation button? Now, if you lock the hands or the feet, you not only lock the rotation, but also pins this part in space. So now we can pin the feet and also lock the rotation of the abs, and we can do this kind of frisky movement. Now, while I show you a practical example of how I hit a pose, I want to say the most sincere thank you to all the nice people that use the app. And even knowing that it was just born and surely could be improved where it was lacking, they left a 4 or 5 star review. This really means a lot to me. It means that this idea that was really born to help me drawing tough poses, even if it's not fully developed, is still something that someone else is appreciating and enjoying and finding useful. You know, for me, publishing PoseIt was this super hard target that somehow I managed to achieve, because, you know, I'm not a professional programmer. And that was already fantastic for me. But then your feedbacks and positive reviews really motivated me to invest some more weekends, some more effort into this app, and made me try to make it even better. So I really hope this new feature makes it easier for people that were struggling before. I have one more feature I really want to add. It has been requested and really feels needed. Hopefully it won't take too long. I don't want to say what it is already, because, you know, what happens if I don't manage to do it. But if you want a hint, I can tell you that I now call this guy Adam. Not gonna say anything else. Okay, keep drawing, guys. And if you want, let me know what would you love to see coming next to PoseIt. I was thinking maybe adding proxies would be cool, like a sword or a gun or a skateboard or whatever. Or maybe even adding another mannequin, so you can do like a little scene with two mannequins fighting or whatever. Oh man, that could become complicated to implement. Anyway, or being able to export the model as a 3D object, so you can import it in Maya or in Blender or whatever you're using. Someone was suggesting adding a whole animation system, but that really is out of reach for me. It's a bit too hard. Okay, anyway, thank you for listening and trying the app, guys. I really wish you the best and to have fun with PoseIt, and keep up the good drawing. Bye, guys.